postdoctoral fellowship, the most known among the Marie Skłodowska-Curie actions and a unique opportunity for your personal and professional development. In this video, I will guide you through the details of a funding scheme that supported the career, among others, of several Nobel awarded scientists. I'm Manuel Bianco, and at Euresearch, I'm one of the Swiss national contact points for the Marie Skłodowska-Curie actions, short MSCA. This presentation will have four main topics: an introduction to Euresearch, an overview on the MSCA and the postdoctoral fellowship program, the explanation about who is eligible to apply for this funding, focusing on the Swiss case, and practical information for your application. Euresearch is a non-profit organization mandated by the State Secretariat for Education, Research and Innovation, in short SERI. We promote and facilitate the researchers, organizations and companies in Switzerland to participate in European projects and programs related to research and innovation. Euresearch is a network of highly specialized professionals dedicated to informing, advising and, when possible, connecting you to get the best out of your application and participation to the Horizon Europe program. Network means that there are regional offices covering the world Switzerland. On the page team of our website, I encourage you to get in touch with your regional advisors, as they have a complementary view on this and other funding schemes, and a first-hand knowledge in the implementation phase. Getting back to MSCA, the postdoctoral fellowship is one of the five Marie Skłodowska-Curie actions. We have co-fund, doctoral networks, MSCA in Citizen, staff exchange, and postdoctoral fellowship. Information on each of these actions are available on our website. Excellence and mobility are the keywords better describing the Marie Skłodowska-Curie actions. The program is designed to foster excellence in research and innovation collaborations, knowledge transfer, methodologies and content, as well as in training, supervision and career guidance. To achieve this, the MSCA is built on the following pillars. It is bottom-up and open to the world. All domains or research are eligible, and international collaboration is encouraged. There are no predefined topics. Then, mobility. MSCA are international, intersectional, and interdisciplinary. Contamination with other points of view is a part of the journey towards excellent research. And effective supervision and career guidance. MSCA are designed to create a supportive environment for the researcher's career. Now, light on the postdoctoral fellowship action. The aim of the postdoctoral fellowship is to support the researcher's career and foster excellence in research. It is designed for researchers holding a PhD who wish to carry their research activities abroad, acquire new skills, and develop their careers. Please note the philosophy behind the program is not just about the research subject itself, it's about the researcher's individual career development. In this sense, the career development plan is a very important element. You must have a vision for your career trajectory and training plan. Supervisor and host in your proposal must fit this vision. The postdoctoral fellowship is divided in two possibilities: European fellowship and global fellowship. For the European fellowship, you can choose the length from 12 up to 24 months and is open to applicants of any nationality. The host organization must be in a member state or an associated country. Switzerland for 2025 is considered as an associated to be country. The global fellowship is, on the other hand, reserved only to the citizen of members' country or associated countries, or to long-term residents of those countries. Long-term means at least 5 consecutive years. The global fellowship has a duration that goes up to 36 months. The specificity is in the combination of two phases, outgoing and return phase. In the outgoing phase, the host organization must be in a so-called non-associated fair country, for example, Canada or Japan. The outgoing phase can have a length of 12 to 24 months. The return phase must be in a host institution in a member state or an associated country, and it has a mandatory duration of 12 months. The two fellowships have one common eligibility criterion. At the moment of the call deadline, the researcher must have not more than 8 years research experience in a member state and or associated country. Time away from research and research time spent in a non-associated fair country is not counted. You can find on our MSCA dedicated webpage a link to a spreadsheet to precisely calculate if you are within 8 years. Eventually, please note that on top of the eligibility rules, mobility rules apply. The applicants must not have resided or carried out their main activity in the country of the beneficiary for the European Postdoctoral Fellowship or the host organization of the outgoing phase for Global Postdoctoral Fellowship for more than 12 months in the 36 month immediately before the call deadline. Please contact us if you plan to apply with a Swiss host and you feel uncertain about your eligibility to apply for a postdoctoral fellowship. I've mentioned several times terms such as member state, associated country, fair country. These names might confuse, and you are probably asking what is the status of Switzerland. For 2025, there is a very good news. Switzerland is considered as an associated country to be in the Horizon Europe program. With respect to 2024, this brings to the following changes. Swiss citizens can participate to the Global Fellowship program. Swiss institutions can be host in the European Fellowship program and the return phase of the Global Fellowship. And Swiss institutions can no longer act as the outgoing host of the Global Fellowship. So please note that it is not possible to resubmit your 2024 Global Fellowship proposal. Concerning resubmission in general, the resubmission with the same host is only possible if your application of the previous year obtained a score higher than 70%. For further information on the Swiss status, I encourage you to visit our dedicated webpage that you can immediately find in the home of our website. You can also consider including secondments during your fellowship. A secondment is a period in another organization where you can receive a specific training. A secondment is not mandatory and it must be coherent with the trajectory defined via the career plan. Secondment can take anywhere in the world and there is not a limit of the numbers of secondment. But the overall period spent for them should not exceed one third of the fellowship time. It is also crucial to define the supervisor for the time of your secondment, and it is not to be confused with a short visit or a field work without supervision. If you actually wish to follow a career path outside the academic sector, an additional period of up to 6 months at the end of the project can be awarded to researchers who will spend that period in a non-academic organization established in a member state or Horizon Europe associated country. Another possibility is also to directly choose a non-academic host for your fellowship, for example, a startup. The financial contribution for the researcher provided in the postdoctoral fellowship program is very easily defined. There is 5,990 euros per month for the living allowance. This amount has to be multiplied with the country correction coefficient. For the global fellowship program, two different correction coefficients apply. One for the host of the outgoing phase and one for the host of the returning phase. The Swiss coefficient is 1.63. Then we have 710 euros a month for the mobility allowance, covering travel and accommodation cost. This allowance is automatically added without the need of cost justification. Eventually, we have 660 euros per month for family allowance, if applicable. Then the host institution will receive institutional contribution of 1,000 euros per month for research training and networking. This is the amount to conduct your research for secondment, attending conferences, etc. And also 650 euros a month for management and indirect contribution. Getting more into action. Here are the dates you need to save. 8th of May, the call open. 10th of September at 5 sharp, the call closes. February 2026, results are announced. Proposals are evaluated by three experts for the three evaluation criteria: excellence, impact, and implementation. In case your proposal is successful, you will then have 3 months for the grant agreement signature, and the earliest starting date will be therefore spring 2026. The application must be done through the proposal call that you find on the funding and tenders portal of the European Commission. You have now heard some petabytes of information about the program, the vision behind it, the eligibility criteria, and many other details. So for sure, you will need some time to digest all this information. When you will be sure that the postdoctoral fellowship is the right choice for your career and you are ready to write the proposal, please keep in mind that Euresearch offers on-site proposal writing trainings and proposal review service for applicants with a Swiss host. The proposal review is provided on a first-come, first-served basis and only once per year, so no iteration. Euresearch also offers online tutorial to better prepare your proposal. We will provide the 2025 uploaded video towards the end of May. I wish you now good luck with your career and with your proposal preparation. Before to tell you goodbye, I also encourage you to watch on the Euresearch website the witnesses of previous fellows. This will for sure inspire and give some useful tips. Ciao! Thank you.